Hey, this is Mruduraj and you're watching Learning Wires. In this video, we are going to discuss the applications of DC shunt generator. So let's quickly jump to that topic. Hey, these are the classification of DC generator. And in previous video, we have discussed all these classifications with animation. Animation in its diagram and animation in its wiring diagram. Circuit diagram and wiring diagram, both thing with animation we have studied. And then it is the task to go for the applications. Just previous video, it was of the applications of separately excited DC generator. And we have understood it with very nice examples. And if you want to watch both of that video, the link of that video I'll provide in description box and above here in card. So later on you can watch that thing. Now in this video we are more focused on shunt generator, DC shunt generator. So we are going to see the applications of DC shunt generator. So now let's understand the applications of DC shunt generator. Basically the first application of DC shunt generator is it is used as a source for electroplating process. Generally, the requirement of electroplating process, it's constant output voltage. If you can provide constant output voltage, then that process can be done easily. And thanks to this DC generator, a shunt DC generator, that can be used as a source for electroplating process. If you go for the second application of DC shunt generator, then we can use this DC shunt generator for general lighting purpose. See, what is the basic requirement of general lighting purpose? You turn on the switch, you turn off the switch, and everybody is doing it randomly, right? So load variation is very random and it can happen at any time, at any moment. But in that condition too, it can provide certain amount of constant output voltage. And that is why in this application, DC shunt generator is used. Now we are going to discuss the third application. And that is, we can use the DC shunt generator as the source to charge batteries, right? Why it is like this? The reason is again same. Because this DC shunt generator can provide constant output voltage. So note it down in your mind that wherever you require constant output voltage to do your processes, you can use this DC shunt generator as your source, right? So now let's go for the next application, and it can be used as an excitation source for the large generators, large alternators. You can use as an excitation. One more thing I would like to discuss, but for that thing you need to come closer. I have prepared a separate video, and in that video I have explained that how alternator works, and that too with animation. So if you want to understand the working of alternator with animation, then you can watch that video. It's very interesting and it got more than 30k views, right? So I think you will love to watch that video. So now we'll move for the next application. But suddenly some spontaneous thought come in my mind that before moving ahead, I would request you to give a like to this video. For which purpose I am asking for like? For no purpose. It's almost 1 o'clock at night. I am shooting this video for you all. And it takes too much hard work to shoot this type of videos, right? So for my hard work, if you can give me a like, then that would be the great help, right? And great motivation. So now after talking this all blah blah blah, let's quickly move to the next application. And the next application is, we can use this DC shunt generator as a small power supply. Small power supply, not small power supply, right? So it's my mistake. We can use it as a small power supply. Why we can use it as a small power supply? Because it can maintain its output voltage constant. For small variation of load, still it can maintain the constant output voltage, right? So for that purpose, we can use this DC shunt generator for all these purposes. Now, we are quickly moving towards the all the applications. But before moving ahead, there is a quick short question for you, and the question is on your display. I'm not going to speak that question. You have to read that question and you have to answer that question in comment section below. Why I'm asking for the answer of this question? Because I want to check and I want you to understand this thing, that after watching this video, are you able to learn something, or it is just another YouTube video that you are scrolling down, watching and just forgetting everything. So is this video is really useful for you, for your learning purpose or not? So to check that purpose, I am asking this question and I request you to write the answer of this question in comment section below, so that I can understand that you are learning something from this video, right? So now let's quickly jump to the all the applications. So these are all the applications of DC shunt generator. Just go through these applications. If any point of time you find anything difficult, if you find that you want to learn anything more about DC generator and anything more about electrical engineering, any topic on electrical engineering with animations, right? You want to learn these things with animations, then write those things, write that topic in comment section below, and I'll make video on that topic with animation surely. So do not forget to write whatever you want to learn in comment section below. And in the next video, we are going to see the applications of DC series generator and then after compound generator. So do not forget to subscribe this channel for all these interesting useful videos. And in future, I'm going to make videos on working of DC generator with animations. So do not forget to watch that video, right? So with this in mind, until we meet again in our next video, till that time, bye bye.